glamour, acts of magical conjuration, hypnotic delusion and illusion, hysterias, fads, pseudo-revelations, strange truths whispered in every quarter. This is the character of our time. And people have seemed to believe that they were fulfilling their responsibilities intellectually. People seem to feel they are doing that when they reject the past. Say, well, you know, that was all screwed up, but since I got with Master Shuggy, I've understood, you know, the way it really is supposed to be. No, this is just trading one set of neotenizing operating systems for another. The real hard choice that you're being pushed toward and that you might consider making before the yawning grave rings down the curtain on this cosmic drama is actually intellectual responsibility, freedom, and a devotion to what scientists call elegance of thought. You know, people say, well, how can you tell one theory from another, and is science better than religion, and this and that? After a lot of arm-waving, it should be conceded that the final call is aesthetic. That because we are monkeys, because we are so far from God, we cannot set knowing the truth as the standard for choosing among the models we can produce. We must set our aesthetic compass towards the more true. And then the question is, well, how do you recognize that? Well, this is a rich field of human study called philosophy of science, or theory, epistemology and ontology. Plato said, you know, that the key lay in the concepts the good, the true, and the beautiful. The good, what is it? Tricky, tricky, tricky. The true, what is it? Trickier, even trickier. The beautiful, what is it? Easy to discern. The beautiful is easy to discern. You are going to be condemned to live out the consequences of your taste. And if you have no taste, you know, God help you. Because you are self-condemned to an appalling nightmare. You won't be getting it. All the subtle stuff will go by you while your head is filled with cant, nonsense, foolishness.